Okay, so all I put in this bin is just some of this Jiffy natural and organic seed and mix start. This is a 12 quart bag. Okay, so I got that at Walmart, and then I have these bins. So what I did was I put a little bit in the bin, and then I threw a little bit of water in there to get it a little bit damp, but I think I need more water. Just a tiny bit more water in there. And then I also bought these like starts. I don't know what you would call them. Like they're just like the little trays. So this brings 72 cells. So in each cell, just put some of the soil in it. And then I'll add like 2 or 3 seeds. And it brings the bottom pan so you can put the water down there. And then on Amazon, I bought 2 of these heating mats. I bought 2 of those. I just have everything on my counter right now because I'm starting off a small one first just to see. And I really don't have room to put another one. I'll have to find somewhere around the house to put the other one. But this is what I'm doing. And then I also have the seeds. So I went on Amazon. And then I found this brand, and it brings like, how many? Like 43 assorted seeds. Now, I did have some seeds left over from the previous year, which I just added in here, and then I put everything in Ziploc bags. So give me a second, let me just pull one out. So what I did was, is that I went through each bag and, or through each seed, I put like items with the like items depending on their growing season or when you start, when they should be started. So I organized them that way. So everything that I have in here in this little Ziploc bag, I wrote on it, start seed in May, transplant in July, and then you can harvest anywhere between September and October. So these are all the seeds that I'm gonna start in May to plant. So the ones that I am starting for March, I put in this bag. So I have March and July, because you can start them in March and then you can also start them in July. So if I start them in March, I will transplant them in the soil or in my pots in April, and then harvest them in June. And then if I do it in July, I will transplant in late August and harvest them in October. And then I did the same thing for everything else. Okay. Same thing with my carrots. And it's just, I just have a whole bunch of different seeds in there. So I'm going to start with this pack. And I'm just going to do like maybe 2 seeds per cell. So let me just get this out of the way. And then I'll get started with this. So I'm gonna throw a little bit more water here. Not a lot, just to get it a little bit more damp than what it is. Mix it up with my hands. I cannot find my gardening gloves whatsoever. So it just means I'm gonna have to go out and buy some more. So now it's like a little bit more damp. You see they're like starting to like, and you can put it into a ball. So that's how I want mine. Right now, just like really damp. Just keep mixing this. Okay, just keep mixing. And that's sort of the consistency that I want for it. All right, now I'm gonna put them in the sauce. Okay, so the seeds that I'm starting in March, I have 1, 2, 3. I have 3 different types of tomatoes. Okay, now these are the ones that I had from last year, and then these are the new ones that I bought on Amazon. Okay, so we have the beefsteak tomato. Okay, I got cherry tomatoes, which is my daughter's favorite. And I got Roma tomatoes, okay? So I'm gonna start these different three different tomato plants. And I'm gonna put two per cell because that's what I want. The cells are pretty small, so I wanna at least put two just in case one doesn't make it. I have another one. All right, so I have that. I also have lettuce. And I have like a lot of different types of lettuces here. Okay, so I have three different types of lettuce. I have the black seeded Simpson lettuce. I have the Parrish Island lettuce. And then I have the butter crunch lettuce. Don't mind my nails, I was playing with dirt. Okay, so those are the three different types. And then I have spinach. I have broccoli. I have cilantro. I have the Cubanelli peppers. I love these peppers. Absolutely love them. These are what I use to make sofrito along with the cilantro. And then we have some spicy ones. I have also the hot pepper, habanero peppers. I have the Italian pepperoncini peppers. We have some peas, and then we have kale. Okay. So I'm gonna get these cells filled up with the dirt that I just mixed. I might have to do a little bit more, but if I do, that's okay. I just don't wanna empty the whole bag in this bin and then not need it, you know? All right. So I'm just gonna get them filled. And then I know I'm gonna dirty my counter, but I'll just have to clean that up. Actually, let me try it this way. So if any dirt falls, it falls in here. Each cell filled. I'm gonna pack it, but not too tight. I did also get some grow lights, but I haven't set those up yet. And it's just like here. I need to find something. I need to like. What do you say? I need to see how I can get those lights because they're like the ones that bring the wire, so you have to hang them on something, either on the wall or from the ceiling, and I don't want to do that here in my kitchen. That's something that I want to do in the basement, but I can't. I'll have to see if my husband will do it for me. Alright, so I like how these are, so let's move this dirt so I can put the other ones. It's a little bit perforated here, so I can cut this tray in half if I wanted to. But I have a lot of seeds that I want to get planted. Or the seeds started, not planted, but started. I'm just gonna break it off. Just makes it easier. Oh yeah, so much better. I don't have that big dry thing hanging. So I just wanna make sure that there's enough just show you. I just want to make sure that there's enough soil in each of the cells. Like I said, I want to pack it, but not too tight. Just enough. Okay, so that looks like This one is a little bit more. So you can see that. I'm just gonna go check that one. Like I said, it's packed, but it's not tight in there. All right, so I have, let me just move it into this tray over here. Move this out of the way. Move this tray in here. You guys can see this better. All right, move that tray in there. Okay, so I have my seeds, I have my little wooden sticks. Okay, so these I just got at the Walmart as well. So I got this one, it's a 150 pack. So I'm gonna rip these open and I'm gonna just decide what I'm gonna put in each of the cells. So I'm gonna start off with my Roma tomatoes. Okay, this is what I'm gonna start with, and I'm gonna do, let me see, maybe 2 cells of each, maybe. Okay, so I'm gonna start with these. These are my Roma tomatoes. I'm gonna do 2 seeds per cell. And they're very tiny. They're very, very tiny. Okay, so I'm gonna grab 2 per cells. Let me get my little stick. I think it'll make it easier if I just poke. So I'm gonna do one in one corner, one in another corner. That way it's easier for me if I want to like separate it. Okay, now it says to plant 1.25 centimeters, that's about right. Okay, so I'm gonna do one. Okay, one there, cover that one up. One there, cover that bad boy up. Okay, so that cell is done. And just cover those up. Okay, that's, I'm only gonna do 3 cells because I have a very tiny backyard, and most, or I want to say all of these are getting transplanted into containers. Now, I do have different types of containers. Let me just write down what they were. So this is Roma tomato. And I'm gonna write today's date as well. Date that they were. Okay, so Roma. Next one I'm going to do are the beef steak tomatoes. And again, the three. Now, this is a learning experience for me. This is my first time growing seedlings. So this is growing experience just to see how I do. I gotta change something. You know, we all learn from our mistakes. And then these are the beef steak tomatoes. So I'm just gonna put beef tea and today's date. Tomatoes. Okay. Again, very small seeds. Oops, one's just fell in here. Got it. There we go. And then this. Oh, did I just do four? Yes, I did. Oh, well. Did I miss this one? Yes, I did. Oh. All right, whatever. My daughter loves these tomatoes, so I'll do four. No biggie. That's a little. No biggie. Guess I did four cherry tomatoes. Well, we have kale. Kale, I really never have grown kale, but I really want to start making some. Reason why I'm trying to grow the kale is because I want to try making some juices. So I heard the kale is really good in a smoothie, so that's why I'm trying to grow some kale. Let me just take a second and just poke the holes in all of these because it just makes it easier when the holes are already poked. Are you using my fingers easily? Yeah. Yeah, my finger was easier. Okay. So I'm gonna do kale next. This is the dwarf blue curled kale. Really tiny as well, and they're round and black, look like little tiny pellets. I like spinach, but my husband doesn't like spinach. So this is the Bloomsdale long-standing spinach. Next one is broccoli, and this one's the green sprouting broccoli. It's an heirloom variety. All of these are heirloom, these little green packages. Let's see what these look like. This is what these look like. Okay. Careful not to lose them. The next one is coriander or cilantro. We love cilantro. So, and we use it every day for cooking all the time. So this one, I might want to plant more than just 3 cells. So I might do 1 cell for now. Because I have a really big pot for this one. So I'm gonna do like a whole cell. Hopefully it'll fit. Let me see. Yeah, it'll fit because it should be. I'm gonna do this and then these, I'll do like the peppers and stuff. Okay, and then these seeds are so much bigger. Okay. These are the seeds. I make sofrito with it, and that's what I use to cook. And sometimes I like to have fresh sofrito, like to put in the rice or put in the beans, or like to put with salsa, with like tomatoes, or if I'm making like a dish that I want that taste of the cilantro in, I'll just throw that in there. And in the Spanish culture, that's a lot of dishes. So definitely need a lot of cilantro. Okay. That's 6 of these. First, before doing all of this, I should have everything already prepared, so that way I just had to put the seeds in and then just not worry about the sticks. But again, this is a learning experience, and now we know for next time. So cilantro. Okay, next one that I'm going to do is going to be the peppers, the Cuba, I don't know if I'm saying it right, the Cubanelli peppers. And these are another thing that I like, to put in my sofrito. And also, just when I'm cooking and I want to throw it fresh in one of my dishes, I just cut it up in, you know, little tiny slivers, you know, dice it up really small. And then I'll just throw it in with my beans or with my rice as well. It just gives it a nice different type of flavor. So this is really, really good. And just something that I started putting in my sofrito, and I actually really like it. So I want to try and grill this. So for this one, I might do, I think 3 or 4 cells I'll do of this one. Okay, and then this is what the seeds look like. They're just like little, you know, seeds that you would find inside a pepper or something. close this up. I don't want my seeds to spill out. Alrighty. We have hot peppers, pepperoncini peppers. Okay, so what are you gonna do? Maybe I'm gonna do one cell of these because we like these in our sandwiches, but it's not something that we it's not something that we really eat. So I'm gonna do maybe one cell of it, and then whatever we get out of it, I'll see if I could like make like a pickle out of it, so that way we can use it on our sandwiches, because that's the only way I think that we like these. So I'm just gonna do one cell. Now, I tried to grow these last year, but the issue was that I planted them too late. They did sprout, and it did, grow its leaves and everything, but it was too late in the season, and I didn't have time to give me any peppers whatsoever. So that was an epic fail on my part. Again, I'm new to this, and I'm just trying to learn as I go. Italian pepper. This one needs a little bit more dirt. And so does this one. Okay. Next one is the habanero peppers. These are the hot peppers. Now, I like spicy. And everybody likes spicy. It sucks. Especially my grandma. So I'm gonna do just one cell of these because I know it's gonna, I don't want too much of it either. Okay, I have the peas and three lettuces left. So I don't even think that I need to use this cell right now because I can just simply use these. So I'm only gonna do, let me see, I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 cells left. So I'll do one cell of peas. And then I'll decide which one's gonna get two cells of these. I'll decide one cell of these. One cell of the peas. Oh, these are huge. Because they're peas, duh. Okay. They're just dried up peas. Okay, I think I'm gonna do one of the black seeded Simpson lettuce. I'm gonna do one cell of this, two of these. The lettuce, the Parrish Island. I'm gonna do two of these and one of this, the butter crunch. Do the butter crunch. Make that mistake of putting it on the ledge. I'd rather put it in the tray. All right, so there you go. Okay, that's the last seed. Put these in here too. Now, the reason or the way that I figured how to plant or when to start my seeds is I went online and I went to the Urban Farmer website. And so I'm in zone six, okay? I'm in zone six. I'm right over here in lovely Rhode Island. So this is all zone six. So per the Pantene schedule for zone six, it gives you like some things that you can start. Obviously this is not all of it, but you can sort of estimate, because if like I said, if you do like things by like things or whatever. So we have here in March, we have, you know, mid-March you can start your beets, beginning of March your broccoli, cauliflower, kale, lettuce, onions. These are mid-March. Peas, mid-March. But I decided to do them the beginning of March. Spinach and your tomatoes, again, in mid-March. But again, I decided to start them the first of the month, because I don't mind if they're inside for a little bit longer, because it seems like we're gonna continue to our frost, or it's gonna be cold out basically for a while. So I'd rather give them a little bit of more time, maybe like another 2 weeks indoors, just in case, you know. I don't want my plants to, you know, to freeze over or anything like that. Like, this is my first time doing it and I want to make sure that I do it right. I did, however, in I believe it was October, I did put plant some garlic outside. So I did check and I did see them sprouting, so that's very exciting. Hopefully I do get to harvest them. Harvest season for the garlic is in like anywhere from, it's late summer, so it would be August, starting in August to September, to early September. So that's when I would harvest that. Hopefully I get something from it. I planted a whole head of garlic, so fingers crossed that, you know, I get something from that. even though I did see some sprouts coming out already. So wish me luck on that one. Let me put the stick here so I don't forget what this one is.
Okay, so your plants are beautiful. Thank you. And you planted tomatoes? I planted tomatoes. Yes, I did plant some tomatoes. Yeah, and I can, and we can make some spaghetti. Yes.
So, sorry, honey. All right, so I already have everything labeled, everything in here how I want it. So I'm gonna get these seeds out of here. My mat, I turned it on. It's nice and warm. I don't have my lights on, but I think it'll be fine if I just, you know, put water and leave it here on the mat for now. And then once they start like sprouting, then I'll put my lights on. Hopefully that's how it is. I'm not sure if I have to put it on when I put the seeds in, or do I put the lights on while they do the germination in there and they start to grow, or after they, I see the first seedling come up. Who knows? Oh, we'll see. We'll see. If anybody knows, let me know, because like I said, this is my first year attempting this, and I know this it's not gonna be perfect. Yes, I know it's not gonna be perfect, and you know, I'm not gonna get, you know, the best results like right away. I know it takes time, and then, like I said, it's a learning experience. But if anybody knows, I would appreciate the advice or the help. And you know, it's good to, you know, bounce ideas off of other people and, you know, help each other. You know, I mean, I don't have a huge garden. Like, my yard is very tiny, and we're thinking about probably just planting in pots, maybe getting like one or two raised beds that we could probably put somewhere in our yard. Or we have two driveways, so maybe we could put something in the driveway that we don't use at all. Maybe turn that into my raised garden field or something. Who knows? But I'm gonna get some water. Like, these are already damp. So I didn't show you, but these cells come with little holes. They have little holes at the bottom. You see them? So if I put water in here, the water, the moisture will seep up into each cell. So I'm not gonna water these from the top. I'm just gonna put the water in the bottom. It just makes more sense to me to do it that way, and I've seen people do it that way, so I'm gonna try it. Okay, so I'm gonna put the plants on the mat. Let me move this over here. Well, let me move you guys real quick. So I'm gonna put this on the mat. Be careful. Be careful. The mat is already plugged in. It's warm. It's a 2-foot mat. I have another one. I'll show it to you guys. Let me just get the water from here. A little bit of water. And of the cells. Let me see if I can move over. Enough, maybe a little bit more.
No, it's
but just a little bit more. I don't want to drown them either.
Mom, they're not dog food.
But that should be fine.
Mom, it's just a muffin.
Okay. Like I said, they're already damp, so I'm just gonna leave them here. Let's see. Hopefully this cover fits. Wait, it's the back ones. Hold on. Get down, honey. Oh, did I put the salt in? No. The salt's not. Yeah, I didn't know. I did it. Actually, the tray goes the other way. So my sticks are, I put my sticks in wrong. But who cares? They're only sticks. Actually goes this way. It's sealed, so, and it has the heat mat on the bottom, so hopefully this works. I mean, it's not a lot, it's a little. I'm starting little, but then again, I got so many other things that I have to plant as well. So I bought two of these and I think it should be fine with what I have and for my size of garden that I'm gonna have. So I'm just gonna clean up and, oh, actually, you know what? I wanted to show you the lights. Let me show you the lights. Let me grab the lights. Okay, so I'm gonna show you the mat that I bought from Amazon. Okay. I'll show you everything. Okay, so this is the Fairy Moss Pro Hex Kit, the seed starting. It brings, like I said, 72 cells, and it's great, great, I hear. So I bought two of these, and as you saw, I only use half for all those seeds. And then this, the mat came obviously in here. I got it off Amazon. It's a seed starter heat mat. Tells you instructions and everything. And it obviously is no other instructions with it, but it's a 10 by 20 seed starter heat mat. And again, I got it off of Amazon. I can try and link it for you guys. And this is just how big it is, you know, and it brings the cord and everything. So it does tell you, you know, seedling, heat mat, the crop that you're growing, the average temperature, and approximately how many days to germinate it's gonna take for that plant to obviously grow. So this is pretty good. And jumping, the light that I got. So these are the lights. It's two rows of lights, you know, it's LED lights. And it brings these little hooks in here or something that I have to like connect with a wire and like hang on somewhere. So obviously it would go like this over the plant. So I'm like trying to figure out that maybe, I know they sell the one with the stand. That's the one that I thought I got. But no, this one you have to hang. It brings a wire for you to hang it off the wall. So it brings these little wires and knobs and all the stuff that you need in order to hang it. But I'm thinking if I can maybe find like a little stand, maybe I could just put a little stand over it like this to just hold it. Should be fine. I don't know. Or maybe I should just return it. I don't know. We'll figure it out. So I just wanted to show you that. Okay. And that is that for this video. Hopefully, you know, I start to see something. I will record the progress for you guys, and just wish me luck. hopefully I get something out of this. Again, thank you so much for watching my video. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. And don't forget to share this video as well. Help grow my channel. That way we can all help each other out, learn, and just try and grow our own food. You know, I know things are expensive and everything, and nothing better than having your own homegrown food. So it's just something that I really wanted to do for my family. So hopefully, you know, we can do something. And I do have other little projects too that I will take you along with. I do have some stuff that I do have to can. I did start canning. I will show you my canner on our next video and the process and everything. And we can start canning together as well. So thank you so much again for watching this video. Don't forget to hit that like button and comment down below. Give me some advice, some suggestions, please. Any advice would be helpful. Again, thank you so much for watching. Have a nice day. Bye.